श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरि ओम। सो वी सॉ कारणा कार्य एंड करणा। आफ्टर सीइंग दि कार्य कारण करणा वी विल कम टू दि प्रमाणा।
दि फर्स्ट इज प्रत्यक्ष डायरेक्ट परसेप्शन।
लॉजिशियंस एक्सेप्ट फोर प्रमाणास्। प्रत्यक्ष अनुमान उपमान शब्द वी ऑलरेडी हैव सीन दिस।
सो प्रत्यक्ष 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 प्रमाण प्रमा प्रमा दिस इज करण दिस इज ज्ञान। फॉर प्रत्यक्ष फॉर प्रत्यक्ष वी एक्सेप्ट इंद्रियार्थ सन्निकर्ष इंद्रियार्थ सन्निकर्ष। सो
दि प्रत्यक्ष इज
इंद्रियार्थ सन्निकर्ष जन्यम ज्ञानम।
दिस इज द डेफिनेशन फॉर प्रत्यक्ष। इंद्रिय अर्थ सन्निकर्ष जन्यम ज्ञानम प्रत्यक्षम। इंद्रिय दि सेंस ऑर्गन एंड दि अर्थ सेंस ऑब्जेक्ट व्हेन दे मीट दि नॉलेज दैट टेक्स प्लेस इज प्रत्यक्ष।
Pot and in the eyesight and pot meets
the knowledge that takes place is pratyaksha. This is of two types, savikalpaka and nirvikalpaka.
And nirvikalpaka.
सविकल्पक मीन्स सप्रकारकं ज्ञानम्, नॉलेज विथ दि एडजेक्टिव।
निर्विकल्पक मीन्स
निष्प्रकारकं ज्ञानम्, नॉलेज डिवाइड ऑफ एडजेक्टिव।
लाइक दिस इज पॉट।
इस सविकल्प का
दिस इज समथिंग। इस निर्विकल्प का
दिस इज समथिंग आई इदम किंचित। दिस नॉलेज इज निर्विकल्प का। आयम घटः दिस नॉलेज इज सविकल्प का। I am ghataha, this is pot, is savikalpaka. Idam kinchit, this is something, is nirvikalpaka. So,
indriya artha sannikarsham janyam jnanam is pratyaksha. This sannikarsha is the key here. So, sannikarsha means the meeting, the connection, the conjugation of sense organ and sense object.
So this sannikarsha is of six types. The sannikarsha is of six types.
First is sanyoga. Sanyoga means pot and the sense organ.
Pot and the eye.
This means it's called a Sanyoga. Okay, next is a Sanyukta
Samavaya.
Next here in this is Sanyukta Samavaya. Pot The sense organ meets the pot, ghata. This is Sanyoga. The sense organ, ghata and rupa, they meet, it is a samavaya. Pot and the sense organ, they meet in Sanyoga. In pot exists rupa, the color, the form, that is a inseparable relationship, therefore that is samavaya. Okay, so Sanyoga samavaya. In the second stage, Sanyoga becomes Sanyukta. Sanyoga is the first stage. In the second stage, it becomes Sanyoga. Okay. Third is Sanyukta Samaveta Samavaya. Sanyukta Samaveta Samavaya. Sanyukta Samaveta Samavaya means you have part. Now, the sense organ meets the pot, this in Sayoga. Okay, in the pot you have Rupa, that is in Samavaya. In Rupa, there is Rupatva. Colorness. That colorness is in Samavaya also, inseparable relationship. Sanyoga, Samavaya, Samavaya. In the second stage, Samavaya becomes Samaveta. In the second stage, Sanyoga becomes Sanyukta. In the second stage, Samavaya becomes Samaveta. Sanyukta, Samaveta, Samavaya. Samaveta is also Samavaya. Instead of saying Sanyoga, Samavaya, Samavaya, we say Sanyukta, Samaveta, Samavaya. That's all. Okay. This is the third Sannikarsha. The fourth Sannikarsha is a Samavaya. Though we have already seen what Samavaya is, we are seeing here in a separate form. See. Sense organ of ear and the sound, they meet, that is in Samavaya. The sound and sense organ of ear, when they meet, that is in Samavaya. Because in the ear, we have space. That space is what helps to hear. Therefore, under the space, the attribute of the space is Shabda. Shabda and space are in Samavaya Samanda. Therefore, it is in Samavaya. Okay. Next is Samaveta Samavaya. The ear and the sound, Shabda is in Samavaya Samanda. Shabda and Shabdatva are also in Samavaya Samanda. Ear and Shabda, ear and Shabdatva. Shabdatva. This is Shabdatva. Shabda is in Samavaya Samanda. Shabdatva is in Samavaya Samanda, therefore Samaveta Samavaya. The last is Visheshana Vishesha Bhava Samanda. So, I see the absence of pot on the ground. Bhutala घटाभाव. सो आई से घट अभाववत
भूतलम,
घट अभाववत भूतलम.
आप ग्राउंड विथ एब्सेंस ऑफ पॉट, पॉट एब्सेंस, ग्राउंड विथ पॉट एब्सेंस. पॉट एब्सेंस इज एडजेक्टिव, ग्राउंड इज एडजेक्टिफाइड, देयरफॉर
एडजेक्टिव एडजेक्टिफाइड
रिलेशनशिप. यू कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड इट इन एनी अदर वे, यू कैन ओनली अंडरस्टैंड इट थ्रू विशेषण विशेष भाव संबंध. घट अभावत भूतलम.
ओके, सो दिस इज द प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण एंड इट्स अ सिक्स सन्निकर्षास. नाउ वी गो टू द नॉर्मली इन द टेक्स्ट ही टेक्स अप
अनुमान प्रमाण,
बिकॉज अनुमान प्रमाण इज मोस्टली एक्सेप्टेड बाय एवरीवन, दैट इज वन रीजन.
एंड the logicians primarily depend upon this pramana, anumana pramana, for proving things. So that is their forte. So they introduce you to anumana pramana, but for us we change this whole system.
We'll see upamana. Upamana upamiti. This is pramana, this is prama, this is karana, this is jnana. And for upamana,
through upamana to gain upamiti,
you have to have sadrushya jnana, the knowledge of
similarity. The knowledge of similarity. To the knowledge of similarity, the knowledge you gain is upamiti. Like you don't know what an oxen is, what an ox is. So you hear from some, or bison, you don't know what a bison is. You hear from someone that a bison is similar to your bull or your cow. Okay, now after listening bison is similar to cow, you go to the forest, and in the forest you see a cow, an object which has similarity with cow. There you understand
this knowledge is sanya sangi sambandha jnana.
There you understand that this is the word meaning of a bison.
Bison is sanya, and the object is the relationship between the word and the object is upamiti. The relationship between the word and the object is upamiti.
This is one important pramana.
Vedantins also accept upamiti. Though Vedantins don't accept the visheshana vishesha bhava sambandha, we may accept the other sambandhas. We don't accept the visheshana vishesha bhava sambandha, because
for us Vedantins we accept abhava pramana itself, anupalabdhi pramana, as a separate pramana.
Next is shabda. Shabda, shabda, pramana, prama, karana, this is ज्ञाना
शब्द मीन्स वर्बल टेस्टिमनी शब्द मीन्स वर्ड शब्द मीन्स वर्बल टेस्टिमनी ओके सो
व्हाट इज शब्द हियर वाक्यार्थ ज्ञान इज दी करण
वाक्यार्थ ज्ञान इज दी करण
Now,
what is a shabda? What is the
shabda pramana? What is shabda? Apta vakyam. What is apta? Yatartha vakta.
One who says as it is called as apta. Okay? One who says things as it is called as apta.
What is vakya? Vakya is a pada samuha.
Group of words is called as vakya. Group of words is called as vakya.
What is pada? Shakyam.
That which is having the power is called as a pada. That which has the power to give the knowledge of word sense is called as pada.
What is shakya? What is the power we call? Ishvara Icha.
Shakyam is a Ishvara Icha, the desire of Ishvara, God. Ishvara wanted to call this a pin, therefore this is called a pin. And pot is not called as pin because Ishvara wanted it to be called as pot. This is why we call as Ishvaraicha.
Ishvaraicha is the Shakti that is called as Shaktya, and that Shakya which is there is called as Pada.
Some gaga buga, taka taka, jiggy jiggy, bugu bugu is not a word, proper word, because there is no desire of Ishvara in that, there is no shakya, shakti in it to manifest some meaning.
So that shakti which has is pada, and that group of pada is vakya, and that vakya uttered by apta is a shabda,
valid pramana,
and that valid knowledge is the means for
jnana, shabda jnana,
verbal testimony. Okay, so vakyartha jnana we said is the cause for, the instrument for the knowledge.
Now how is this vakyartha jnana decipher?
Vakyartha jnana, he says, vakyartha jnana is karana. This is three types: akanksha, yogyata, sannidhi.
Akanksha, yogyata, sannidhi.
Akanksha means anvaya,
the connection between one word and other word is akanksha. Expectancy, akanksha means expectancy, fulfilling expectancy of one word. When I say pot, what is pot? This is pot. When I say this, what is this? There is expectancy, pot. So one word, if it fulfills another word's expectancy, that is what is called as a akanksha. Yogyata means eligibility. The word, whatever I say, should not be negated by any other means or any other pramana.
Artha abhada, we call it artha abhada. Artha abhada.
Like there is a statement in the Vedas, Vannina Sinchet, sprinkle with fire. It cannot be possible. So those kind of statements are not a pramana.
Sannidhi.
Sannidhi means, okay, bring pot or this is pot. When I say, statement is okay. But instead of saying bring the pot, I say B, R, and after 1 hour I say I, that does not have, or Br, Ing, there is no sannidhi there. Sannidhi means avilamba uchcharanam. Avilamba uchcharanam. Spelling it without delay. Saying it without delay is what is a sannidhi. So these are important. And for the vakya to gain pramanya, what is vakya pramanya? Which vakya has the validity, eligibility? Which is the valid proof? For that we have two. One is laukika pramanya, laukika vakya pramanya, and vaidika. In vaidika, everything is pramana. There is no word in the Vedas which is not valid. Everything is a valid proof. But in the laukika, in the world, laukika means loke bhava, that which is seen, heard in the world. So in the world, only the statements said by apta is pramana. The statements uttered by apta is pramana. So we will say aptoktam. Aptoktam eva sarvam. Vaidikam, in Vaidikam sarvam pramanam. In laukikam aptoktam eva pramanam. So this is the idea we gain from the shabda. Next is anumana. We'll spend some time in anumana. Hari Om.